SIFA 19
Call of Duty, Black Ops 4, and Red Dead Redemption, two were the most downloaded titles on the PlayStation Store throughout 2018. The news comes straight from Sony, with the company naming the top 20 most downloaded PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita titles in a post on the PlayStation blog. Familiar names like Beat Saber, Job Simulator, and Super Hot were topped the PlayStation Vita download charts, and were joined in the top 10 by the likes of Skyrim and Moss. Although the console maker did not reveal any exact download figures, it's still interesting to see which games thrived on its digital marketplace. Last year, we have spotlighted the 10 most downloaded PS4 and PS Vita games below, but those interested can check out the full lists by clicking right here. PlayStation Store's most downloaded PS4 titles. PlayStation Store's most downloaded PS Vita titles. There's a bold compliment of game makers out there braving the fringes by designing interactive entertainment for platforms like Netflix and Amazon's Alexa, and at this year's Game Developers Conference you will have an opportunity to learn from some of the best. Notably, in his GD2019 Game Narrative Summit talk, The Invisible Escape Room, adapting Jack Ryan for Alexa, game industry veteran LucasArts, Telltale, etc., and DeepLay Chief Creative Officer Dave Grossman will give you a rare overview of the unique game development challenges presented by voice-controlled narrative for voice assistants, and, by extension,
AR/VR.
Using Earplay's recent adaptation of a physical escape room to a Jack Ryan-themed interactive story on Alexa, as a key example, Grossman will examine the ins and outs of story creation for voice platforms, adaptations between media, and how to direct an exploratory experience when the audience cannot see anything at all. It's a select opportunity to learn practical strategies for a mood medium of game design from an industry vet, so do not skip it. For more details on this talk, and many more, check out THEGDC 2019 session scheduler. There you can begin to lay out your DD week, which takes place March 18th through the 22nd at the newly renovated Moscone Center in San Francisco. Bring your team to DD, register a group of 10 or more and save 10% on conference passes. Learn MORE. For more details on GDC 2019, visit the show's official website, or subscribe to your regular updates via Facebook, Twitter, OS, Gunnar Sutra and DD are sibling organizations, under parent company Informa. Hey Game Makers, organizers of the Game Developers Conference Air Excited Tour this year, introduced the DD main stage, a first-of-its-kind marquee presentation, on the opening day of DDE's main conference. Each year, this multi-speaker main stage presentation will invite attendees to gain inspiration and insight into creative challenges and opportunities unique to the game development community. The inaugural DDE main stage presentation, entitled The Developer's Journey, will take place at the Moscone Convention Center's West Hall on Wednesday, March 20th,
2019.
The developer's journey will focus on finding inspiration over the course of a game's development cycle, from its earliest conception through its development, to dealing with the fallout from the release, and the post-release content. The presentation will open with a special musical performance, generated in Media Molecules, upcoming creativity-fueled title Dreams. Media Molecules' Shaobao Ready will then explain how Dreams helps unlock players' creativity in unprecedented user-generated detail. From there, Hello Games' Shamari will discuss how his small and likely team created one of the most ambitious and anticipated games of 2016, No Man's Sky. He will then detail how by 2019, through determination and love, they built to record player numbers and spawn positivity amongst their most negative detractors. This candid and open discussion will show the power of focusing on what you do, rather than what you say, in the face of adversity. Finally, veteran game developer and top-rated ED speaker, Laurie McWilliams, closed out the presentation, discussing how her teams have found resilient inspiration in stressful environments. Laurie will describe how she has stayed optimistic and motivated through unforeseen challenges using proven and inspiring tools and techniques. The first BD took place at Chris Crawford's home, with a small group of game developers exchanging their best advice on how to make games better. We wanted to reflect that same spirit of connection and community that's at the heart of BD by making the main stage a place for all attendees to learn together, said Katie Easton, general manager of the Game Developers Conference. Development can be as rewarding as it is challenging, and one of our goals is to inspire the community to find better ways forward. We are honored to have Xiaobon, Sean and Laroin to light the way. The main stage presentation will be open to RGD conference and Expo Pass holders, and will be live streamed via DDA's Twitch channel, https://twitch.tv/dd, starting at 12:30 p.m. on Wednesday, March 20th. Further details on the main stage presentations and the smorgasbord of DD 2019 talks are available now on THEGDC 2019 session scheduler. There you can begin to lay out your DD 2019, which takes place March 18th through the 22nd at the newly renovated Moscone Center in San Francisco. Bring your team to DD, register a group of 10 or more and save 10% on conference passes. Learn more. For more details on DDC 2019, visit the show's official website. Or subscribe to regular updates via Facebook, Twitter, OS, Goddard Sutra and DD are sibling organizations under parent company Informa. Facebook has rejected a trailer for Grease after deeming its imagery sexually suggestive, a decision which publisher Devolver Digital calls really stupid. Facebook rejected a Grease launch trailer ad for this sexually suggestive. See you so this year is going great so far, Devolver Digital tweeted yesterday afternoon, attached with an image of the scene in question. The scene features a statue of a woman, her shoulders exposed and the rest of her form taking on the look of a tower. Besides her shoulders, there does not seem to be any nudity, and the amount of her body that's visible remains the same throughout the game. A PR professional working WITHDEVOLVER Digital tells Bullet on that Facebook refuses to accept the argument that there's nothing inherently sexual about the imagery. This is really stupid. We appealed and Facebook said the appeal was rejected based on the grounds that Facebook does not allow nudity. They said, first of all, she's a statue and second, absolutely no nudity is shown in that photo, nor is this what any reasonable person would consider sexualized content. They also mention how THEYINCLUDED pictures of sculptures depicting nude men and women found through a Facebook search. These images were publicly available to view on the platform, to which Tinsley suggests is a double standard on Facebook's part. Facebook's community guidelines clarifies that photographs of paintings, sculptures, and other art that depicts nude figures are exceptions to the policy on content including adult nudity and sexual activity. With that in mind, it's interesting that the trailer was still rejected. Devolver has not said whether or not they will submit a different version of the trailer. The Gunatsuchi job board is the most diverse, active and established board of its kind for the video game industry. Here is just one of the many positions being advertised right now. Location: Stanford, Connecticut. Key responsibilities: qualifications. Interested: apply now. Whether you are just starting out, looking for something new,